and viewers alike, it's me, Munchie, and welcome back to today's bad cage review unboxing video. Now, before we get into it, I just want to introduce myself. My name is Munchie. I like to review bad and good cages, and I want to explain to you guys why this cage might not be suitable for you to purchase, and or if you're currently using it right now, I'll explain a little bit more in depth about why this cage should be switched out and you should consider an upgrade and or something more appropriate. Now, I'm mainly going to be talking as a hamster reviewer here, but I am the owner of Munchie's Plates for Homeless Pets. It is a small hamster gerbil and mouse rescue, and I like to advocate that people do their proper research and education on these guys here, because unfortunately, a lot of these cages that you see online are just not appropriate, and people think that they want to buy one cage and it's a done deal. So if you're new here and you see me shining a negative light on this specific enclosure, don't worry, I may be making some good points about it, but it's mainly going to be bad. And of course, I will always show you the brighter side to enriching your fellow hamster, gerbil, or mouse if you are currently using this enclosure. This is one of the best-selling cages online. It is very cheap. I bought this under $20 on Amazon, and it is rated pretty high. So I hear some good things about this cage. I hear some bad things. Now, I forgot if this specific model has attachments, but I have yet to open this. I did cut it open so I can easily show you guys, but let's just go right into the review here. Now, as I'm opening up this cage, if you have a hamster, 450 square inches in the United States is the appropriate minimum square inch of floor space for them. For the United Kingdoms, it is about 620 square inches for them, and that is horizontal, unbroken floor space. People out there will probably want to just purchase one cage and that be all. But since this is so cheap, does this work as maybe a travel carrier? Or does this work as a cage itself? Now, I can tell you right off the bat, just by looking at it in its box here, it's not gonna meet the 450 square inch. Now, if you guys know about a 20 gallon long tank, that's 360 square inches, and you know how wide that is. This right here is not it, but we will be measuring it to see the square inch of it. It comes in a nice box. I will give it credit for that. Here it is, and it's already assembled. Look at that. This is gonna be the fastest cage review you probably have ever seen me review. It is, I think it's from the same, yep, it's from the same people that created the Habitrail. Now, the Habitrail has been around for eons. I wanna say they started in the 80s, but this is just care that we've had. 80s, 90s, early 2000s, but there's been better research out there since the early 2000s about hamsters, their stress levels, and their health in smaller than need be enclosures if confined for too long. Let's just take a look at this right here. There is a zip tie, which I was not predicting. Oh no, where's my scissors? Okay, I think I have my scissors in the room. It shows one cage and it says times one. It says upper level area times one. Food bowl times one, wheel times one. I mean, oh, I see. It has connector and that's times two. And they're connector tube solids right here to protect the sides in case you're not going to expand. Cause yeah, it looks like we can expand on this. Okay, very interesting. And so there is also a water bottle in here. Now, it says over on this side, which you won't be able to read because I'm going to be reading it. So it says here, well-ventilated design keeps your hamster's home fresh. Lookout deck with ladder provides climbing exercise. Satisfies your hamster's natural need to explore and hide. And this size, it sure ain't. Round corners and litter guard. Oh, litter guard. Tell me more about this litter guard. It says here, makes cleaning easy and minimizes messes. Let's just take a look. It says deep base, no mess. Not a deep base. Well, maybe it is. So it looks like the base goes all the way up to here because that's where the first wire compartment is. Let me just take this off unless it's tied on. No, it ain't. Oh, what do you know? There's actually instructions on the cardboard, but it says assembly instructions, even though this has already been put together. Wait a minute. There's assembly instructions inside of it too. Wait, what's the point of it then? All my frustrations are peaking. My frustrations are yelling now. It looks like I need to take this off further. Maybe. What? Why? Why is it like that? What's going on? What? What? I'm so confused. What is going on here? Can I open? Can I open? Nope. It's just gonna flap around. Why aren't you secure? All right. It wasn't completely snapped on because I was fiddling with it, but you're supposed to clip it. So let's try to clip it. Clip, clip. Now, how sturdy is, no, it's popping off. I was gonna say, how sturdy is this to prevent this from falling off if you're carrying it or if your hamster is trying to escape? That is very flimsy. I can't even push it in there even further because that's how, as far as it's gonna go. But like, look, if I just slightly tug on it, it pops off. That is a bad design there. Let's see, this angle is a lot better. You see that right there? That is very thin and it just, it can't really grip it. That's the problem with this. You can't grip that tiny, very thin bar. You see how thin the bars are? Not quite ideal. Now, remind you, this is a under $20 cage, which is one of the cheapest cages. Now that we've discovered that, how do I safely keep my hamster secure in here? Is that it? Okay, so to safely secure your hamster, there is kind of like these clamps underneath that you pull down and you lift up, apparently? What's going on? Yeah, you pull down and you lift away, right? Nope, pull down, lift away. Oh, or just break it. Okay, why is this being so difficult? What the heck? Okay, yeah, it's a lift. The directions say it's a lift. So I'm gonna latch it again. You see how it's gonna latch? It's just gonna hook. It's gonna hook like this, so you push it down, you push it. You push. Am I not doing this correctly? Okay, you pull it down. I was trying to fiddle with this, trying to lock it into place, and at first I thought I had succeeded. Turns out I didn't, so I tried it another way, which it seems like this right here is the way it's supposed to be. And it's supposed to stay here, and then if you want to unhook it, you're just pushing this up, and it's supposed to unclip. Now, the problem that I just discovered was I can't get it to lock anymore, but I can't get it to lock the way it was intended to lock. I'm giving up because, honestly, this is terrible. This design is terrible right here. This is awful. So, besides just having that not really working, let's take a look at what it comes with. So it comes with see-through pieces because that is the appeal. They want you to be able to enjoy and see your hamster. This design, honestly, just the way it looks a lot better than the critter trails because they leave it bright and open. And I do applaud them for that. Design-wise, it looks nice. This is a very interesting food bowl. Very interesting. It's bigger than usual food bowls. Want to make a note of that. This up here is supposed to be, yeah, it's supposed to be like a little hive roof. And then there's a tiny little ladder here that looks like only a Roborovsky can fit inside of it. Do people not understand how wide Syrian hamsters get? This is tiny. We got a H2O water bottle, which looks like this. I've actually seen this before. They already got, as you can see here, the layered top on, but it's actually come undone, so let me just try to hook it. You can see right here, there is flimsy plastic with a tiny hook. This I can feel right now just by putting my weight on it. This is very, it's not necessarily rubbery plastic, but it's kind of in between rubbery and kind of hard, cheap like this. And it feels pretty solid right now, but there's only one hook and it's in the middle. Let's go and try to hook the ladder. All right, so the ladder is in. It is at an angle because it looks like you can curve it a little bit. So we're gonna move on to the sides. As you can see here, it came like this. The connector and the stopper here, which is what I'm gonna be calling it, so it prevents the hamster from escaping. They're already together. Go in like this, which is at an awkward angle. So it looks like I was supposed to get it to line up because there are slits right here that kind of line this up so it bulges on the outside. As you can see here, bulging. So line these up. Perfect. And push it on. All right. That seems pretty secure. We are going to put the top on for this. It's supposed to go right here. It's so close to the top though. I don't know how that's supposed to hook. Hold on. We might have to lower this maybe one bar. Oh gosh. Now you have to line up the bars to make sure that's the same height. Does it look good? I hope it's good. So let's put the lid on here, if I can. I kind of wish I can get my hand in here, but I'm just doing this all through the front door. So this is kind of awkward, but it's not looking so solid because there is a gap on this side. And I don't like that. I mean, all the slits are in, they look somewhat secure, but there's just a tiny, tiny little slit right here where it doesn't look like it fits. So, cheap. Cheap is the word I'm gonna use. But now that we have almost everything together, where is this gonna go? Oh, it looks like it wants to go right inside here. Nope, it looks like it's going on the outside. So we get to take this out, wait till it snaps. It's supposed to, oh, what do you know? Look at that, it holds on to it. So it looks like this water bottle is staying in place very well. Okay, that's interesting. It doesn't look like it holds a lot of water in here. So it looks like possibly just 2 ounces and has a short nozzle, so it's not very long, but they do that because you don't really have a lot of floor space. So they're trying to take that into consideration. So it's not a bad design, but it's just, you want more than 2 ounces of water in here. This is plastic, this is not glass, and this is a flexible plastic, not solid, hard plastic like the sides here. But let's put this inside. Let's just put it right over here. And then if we look inside, look at that wheel. It's already in place, it's already in there. I'm gonna spin it. Oh. Oh, it's vibrating. Oh no. Oh, it's vibration is just so bad. What? Oh God, no, please don't squeak at me. Oh no, no, no. Whenever you have a kit that has accessories that come with it, usually you don't need those accessories. You are wasting so much money if you were to have just gone with accessories right off the bat that work, that you like, that you know are good in reviews. Get separate accessories. Don't ever get something that comes with accessories because you're just gonna have to change them out, which is a huge problem. So, because this wheel is so big and so design-wise not the greatest, let's see if we can measure it. Do I seriously have to take this all off? Okay, let's see how easy it is to just take the whole thing off. Oh, it feels like it was glued. Oh, it is glued. Oh, what do you know? But it's not glued with like actual glue. It has tape on the sides. How about that? All right, now that we got that off, let's actually measure this. But before we measure it, look at it here, there's slits. There is actual slits within the wheel. You know why they do this? You might think it's kind of a weird design. They do this so the urine, when they're running and they're peeing as they run, the urine is supposed to get outside of the wheel to make it less messy. But in general, you want to be changing out the wheel every week when you go to spot clean your enclosure, your big enclosure, because that's the way you prevent it from getting gooky in the first place. You should be spot cleaning it when you need to. Because of those slits are there, it is dangerous for smaller hamsters because they can get their foot caught in the slits, and if they just angle it to a certain degree, they might not know how to get their foot out, and so they're trying to push it up. It's like when you perfectly line something up and then you kind of angle it or create like an angle and then you try to get it back out the same way you try to get it in. It won't work. So this is a really big safety hazard, and I'm sure there's gonna be people on Amazon complaining about it. This is a dangerous wheel to use. Have a solid wheel. Now that we've classified this wheel as being an inappropriate wheel to use because of those dangerous slits there, and it should have been just completely solid wheel, let's measure this because this is one of the biggest wheels I've seen come with one of these. It looks like it's 7 inches. Wow, really? 7-inch wheel, guys. This is a first. Now, this size is okay for small dwarf hamsters, Roborovskis. Winter whites might get a little big for this, but there has been some small winter whites, Jungarians, Siberians, that's what they're called. But Campbell's Russian dwarf hamsters, they can get big or they can stay small, but this is only okay size for them. But like I said, guys, it's dangerous because of those slits, so you shouldn't be using it in the first place. There it goes, out of my hands and out of my life. We need to measure the cage, but because I've already disassembled this cage, let's just measure the pan real quick to see how long and how wide it is. Looks like it is 14.5 times 9 inches. 14.5 times 9 is 130.5 square inches. This is very small. So this is not an appropriate enclosure, but you can connect them. However, if you just keep buying the same cage over and over and over and over again with connector tubes to them, what you have is you don't have a very good height and you can't put everything in one enclosure. A solid one and done big deal, you can put hides and mix them up everywhere, but in here you really got to be specific, which is unfortunate because hey, if you want to upgrade your wheel because hey, that wheel sucks, let's put in a big wheel for dwarf. Okay, 9 inches. All right, so because of the size of this wheel, it is higher than the cage itself, and that is the problem. 9-inch wheels are great for dwarf hamsters. Not so great for Syrians, but they can be good for pups, you know, Syrian pups when they are growing up, and for stunted hamsters, which is unfortunate because stunted hamsters, they have health issues and they don't grow past a certain size, which is unfortunate. But hey, if you have a Syrian in here, because reviewers are saying they're putting their Syrians in here, which is horrible to hear. Syrians should be using a 10 to a 12 inch wheel. This is an 11 inch because all my 10 inches need to be cleaned right now. And this is what they absolutely need here. They do not need something like this because as you see, it pretty much eats it up. It's so small. So that is very bad. So besides it being under the square inch of 450 square inches in the United States, this is not a suitable enclosure. Just trying to haggle with it is going to be annoying. But what about measuring the pan depth? Because you need at least on average about 5 inches of bedding just so they can enclose themselves, so they can create warmth and tunnels and keep themselves safe. So it looks like it's 4 inches of pan depth. This is actually a lot bigger than, say, for instance, the critter trails. Yeah, it is okay in that regard. However, it's not 5 inches. And if you want to get it exactly to 4 inches up here, it will be skewing over the sides here. But the good part about this design is it's only the front and back. It's not the sides here, but at the same time, it's just not the greatest cage because it's cheap plastic. This is not latching anymore. Oh, did you latch? No, it's not latching anymore. And I'm trying to get it to like go down and it won't stay. So if this doesn't want to work, I mean, what's the point in keeping it? I'm just probably going to return it because if somebody were to have used this enclosure with this problem saying, you know, I just got this enclosure, I just don't want to change it out, we'll just put zip ties on it. If you put zip ties on it, the hamster one can probably chew the zip ties if it can see it and reach it. I wouldn't be surprised if I found a review that says, oh, the hamster popped off the only accessible door. This is cheap. This is so cheap and so dangerous. This is a dangerous cage. Just the touch and the feel of it, just the bars, being able to bend those bars like that. Like, look, I just bent those two bars together. I should not have been able to. Let me just bend all these bars here in the front so you can see just how bendable they can be. You see that? It's like they're bending so much. So if you accidentally drop this, I mean, look at it. You've already warped the enclosure. Oh my goodness. So you want to know why good enclosures are expensive and not $20? Is because they want to keep your hamster safe. Invest in good cages because cages like this will ruin you. Now you want to know what people tell me, well, you know, I don't have a lot of money. Bin cages are wonderful and you can DIY bin cages. You just put mesh on top on the lids, hardwire mesh. You just get the right type of tools for the job, drills, oscillating tool with a like wood or plastic blade to cut in the lid. And then outside of the lip, you just punch a bunch of holes so you can zip tie the wire to the bin itself and voila, you get a wonderful bin cage. This right here is housing a very special girl. Her name is Buttercup. And I recently got her. She unfortunately was a hamster that was not identified as an aggressive hamster, was given to a family, and unfortunately she does have some head trauma because what happened was, most likely, she latched onto my finger and wouldn't let go. So for the family that previously had her, you probably can guess what happened. Probably latched on, wouldn't let go, and the child or parent or whoever this poor hamster had to latch onto threw it and it probably hit a wall because she unfortunately has stargazing issues. She just constantly is tilting her head up, looking up and sometimes will fall over and do flips. And it's not a good thing when they start like that. She doesn't know her balance because she has head trauma. So the vets have confirmed that and it's awful, but this is her, Buttercup, because she is one of those aggressive dwarf hamsters that, if you're unaware of aggressive dwarf hamsters, please check out my video. But this is her enclosure here. And people say bin cages, oh, you know, bin cages, they don't look so great. Are you kidding me? Look at my lid. I am so happy with my lid. Even though it might not be the prettiest. Oh, I gotta be careful of you. Yeah, you might latch on to my little hairs here. Yeah, look at you, sweetheart. Hi. So even though I might not have duct tape to make the ends look pretty, just cutting that and putting colorful zip ties here. I mean, that's a good job, I wanna say. It is good ventilation, and this bin is clear. You can see through it. I mean, look, she has her own little winter wonderland almost. Oh, look at you flipping over, you poor thing. For her, she does have a 9-inch wheel, which I was able to put in. She has toys and hides that are easy to lay out. She's got tubes and tunnel systems. She has her hide over here. She had a sand bath that she completely dug up on this side. She's got a hide over here. She has a hide right here. She has her own water bottle that's pretty indestructible. And this is just a cheap alternative, which is a safer alternative. You might ask for Syrians, well, can they chew through this? Well, it is possible depending on your Syrian's activity levels and if you have a female that's very young and in heat. But usually for dwarf hamsters, they're not chewing up the sides. So she is completely safe in here, but it is possible with a very large Syrian hamster that is very energetic. They can't get their energy out, and maybe you're not spending enough time with them, or maybe they could be bored, or maybe they're just very destructible because of their age, nature, etc. For her here, she is safe and secure in here. I see no problems with bin cages, and I don't think you guys should either. Which is a better deal here? You see that? You see how small this is? If I just put it over to the side here, look how big it is compared to the bin. This bin is slightly above 450 square inches and slightly below 500 square inches. It's around that range. And if we put it to the side here, you see how small that is compared to the bin. And you want to know how much this bin cost me before I bought supplies for it, which the supplies zip ties are only like $3.99. The hard wire, which comes in a pretty big bundle that's wrapped around, it only costs about $5.99, I think. This bin is only $16.99 and it comes with the lid. So that's a good deal compared to what I had to spend. But yes, you do have to buy individual items, but these items are gonna last and you can provide more pan depth, which is incredible. If you wanna have a hamster that just wants to burrow in a bunch of bedding, go ahead. You don't have to spot clean daily and deep clean weekly. You spot clean with this weekly and deep clean monthly because of how big it is. So with the smaller enclosure, you'll have to take all of that apart, which is gonna be annoying. With this, you have a flat surface area that you can just easily clean. You can easily dump this bin out, not have to take apart anything, and you'll be able to clean it a-okay. By the way, the reason why she's doing this, I call it the tick, because all aggressive dwarf hamsters have it where they're always out, they always wanna know what's going on, and then as soon as you get close to them, they go or they try to latch on to you. But she has a tick that just won't stop. So this behavior right here is normal. It's not because, you know, I'm being very mean to you. She wants to know what is going on. Now, with this, you'll have to take everything apart and you have a confined area. Can I stick one hand in? Yes. Can I stick the other hand in? Yes. Can I scoop it out? Yes. So it works a little bit better with this angle versus other cages that are very similar in design. It doesn't have handles to pick it up. It is lightweight though, but this is also lightweight too, the bin, that is. But it's just, it's not worth investing in something as small as this when you see something that could be useful such as that. So, honestly, I hate this. I hate this more than I think the rocket cage. And the rocket cage, even though it's vertical space, but then again, you guys saw that I couldn't safely put together the rocket cage, but it could have been a manufacturing issue, just like this. It could have been a manufacturing issue or a design issue. It seems like a design issue, but everything you get here for that cheap of a price, it's cheap. It is so cheap. Oh, I don't want to deal with this anymore. So honestly, guys, my review is don't buy that crap. Just don't. Bigger is always better. because these guys deserve it. You want to invest in them, right? You want to have a good relationship of that 1, 2, or maybe even 3 years of their life with you. You don't want to force them in something small like that. You don't want them to start bar biting. You don't want them to become destructive and bored, because that's what they're gonna be. They're gonna be bored. Because I honestly don't want to put my hamster in something like that. I mean, yes, I brought out little Destructo here, and she could go run around and destroy all the plastic inside of that enclosure, but I just don't want to stick her in something like that. She needs so much more, especially since she has that destructive behavior, that frantic behavior, because she unfortunately was bred that way. So thank you guys so much for watching today's review. If you're wondering if I am going to return that, or if I'm just putting money in the company's pocket who makes them, I am returning it. Honestly, I have a valid reason to return it, which is it doesn't latch. So thank you so much. If you liked today's video, hit like, show support. Comment down below with anything you'd like to say about this video or about that. And if you're new here and would like to become a part of the Munchkin family, please subscribe. So, I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye! I also want to note, because I was trying to make the thumbnail for this video, I'm just holding it, and the bottom keeps coming off. And this is another safety issue. I just put this on, you see this right here? It is supposed to clip into the sides, but you see how flimsy and thin that is. So, of course, if you're jiggling it, oh, look at that, I dropped it. It might not be tight, but it can't be any tighter. It doesn't latch properly because the plastic is so pushed in and thin that that's what happens. If somebody is carrying around this cage, say for instance, maybe a child, but if you're just holding it like this and if you push inward or even not even push inward, just holding it, it pops it off. I'm just trying to hold this thing so I can make a thumbnail and it falls off. This is the worst cage that's supposed to mimic better cages from KT or Tiny Tails even, which I hate to say, I'm giving them credit for their design of at least staying put and staying together. This thing is cheaply designed and made. If I push inward, ready? Push. I can't believe there's hamster owners out there that buy this. And they think it's good. I am saying it's not good. It's not good. I am begging people, please listen.